the technology to extrude plastic in order to form a physical representation of a 3D model has been around since the mid to late 80s. The early 90s were probably less than 1,000 3D printers in the world. Now there is approaching hundreds of thousands, if not a million.
We are building the printers that are enabling the innovators of tomorrow. Anything in my apartment, I first look at it and I'm like, can I print this?
I'm really excited about that next plateau. So MakerBot in 2008 was the first to condense and sort of reduce the cost and simplify this crazy lab gear into now a desktop tool. You could get a $1,000 machine, bring it home, put it together, and 3D print something. And that was the absolute bleeding edge of access, of sophistication at that scale.
We definitely started more in like the hobbyist maker movement. And then as we sort of matured as a company, we realized that a lot of the people who actually bought our printers were sort of professional users as well as educators. That being said though, a lot of those people were also makers.
Those machines that our parent company was selling were anywhere between $500,000 and $1 million. To get the cupcake CNC for anywhere between $1,000 and $2,000 is a steal. That massive shrinking in cost is what opened up access in ways that we hadn't seen before.
The hardware has become a lot more polished and easy to use. Now there's a little sensor inside of it. They're a lot faster. They'll have like Wi-Fi, which is cool. This is probably one of the most futuristic things I've done. I was on a plane and I had Wi-Fi and I was like, oh, I want to print that thing for my Nintendo Switch. So I printed it from an airplane and then I sent it to work. And then I was watching it print out while I was like flying across the ocean. I was like, this is pretty cool.
People were talking about everybody being able to access a 3D printer and almost to the point that having it be as commonplace as a microwave. We missed on the microwave. However, it's becoming almost as commonplace as a chalkboard in schools. I only had access to 3D printing in my college degrees. Here at MakerBot, we are enabling students to have access to those printers from the kindergarten years. It's just unbelievable. I've been working with printers for about 10 years, and imagine a kid that starts playing with a 3D printer from, you know, elementary school. Just thinking about what they could do, it's really humbling in a way.
They are in 7,000 schools, and then they're also in like the Lockheed Martins of the world. Anyone who knows Minecraft basically knows how to 3D model, and their like brains are just wired that way. They can like export models from Minecraft and print them right away. So it's super cool. It's sort of like Promethean technology that anyone can get what they want out of it.
What we're really excited about on the hardware side is the experimental extruder.
Since these printers have a magnet on them, anyone can make any tool head for it. Basically, it's hackable, the plans are online, you could print different material from anyone. We've seen tattoo printers hacked, we've seen bio printers hacked. I mean, a lot of what our printers are used for in the medical field is pre-visualization.
It's the same logic of what happens if I had an idea in my hands versus if I had an idea in a flat screen, in a 2D representation. For example, this doctor was creating these tumors after being scanned. Printing the tumor before trying to extract it gives him such a better idea of what he's going to be facing once he's in there. This is one of our most successful prints. It's called the Enable Hand. It's a prosthetic hand for a kid. Kids grow really fast. They need to have a replacement of these items fairly constantly because they are growing. By having a 3D printer execute on this, you can have that item be customized every single time at a cost-affordable price. If you wanted to create something like this in a traditional method like injection molding, you're talking about several tens of thousands of dollars worth of molds. If you 3D print it, it's probably not even $5 worth of material. As you see the object in your hands and you're able to interact with it, you get so much more information than just by thinking about the problem and ultimately better serve the kids that are going to be benefiting.
The industry is growing substantially. We're growing, everyone's growing. The prices are coming down, the accessibility is going up, the tools are becoming easier to use. So I just see it permeating every facet of life.
If I can empower 100 designers who are trying to make an impact for the better in their worlds and in their communities, that for me, it's a big goal. So that everybody can have that opportunity of, you know, if you have a problem, there's a solution for it. There's a way to find a solution for it.